this is my channel, and today we are going to rate my hair. Yes, my subscribers have rated my hair, and I'm going to be doing these every single time I get some new hair from a company. Before we get in this video, make sure you smash that subscribe button, smash that like button, and smash every other button that you know that can help me. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, anything else that you can see that you could follow me on, do that. Okay, now this video is inspired by Lior Gordon. If y'all don't watch her, y'all should watch her. She did a video recently on her friends in her group chat rating her wig, and I was like, ooh, this is nice, I like it. So I completely stole her idea, but hey, at least I gave props, okay? I give the props where it's due, okay? If I steal something, I'm gonna tell y'all where I got it from, okay? I decided I would change it up and do a rendition of her idea, and I would make a subscribers rate my wig. Now, before we get started, this video is sponsored by Eva Hair Wig, and that is the hair that is on my head right now. The thing is, I'm not really into straight hair. Like, y'all already know, usually if I wear, like, a weave or something like that, it's curly. Like, my next weave is going to be a sew, and it's going to be curly. I'm not into straight hair. Like, typically, this is not me. However, I really wanted a bob. Like, I wanted some bobbed hair for quite some time, and I also want some yakky hair. If I could, like, get, like, a yakky wig from a company, like, listen, I would be so happy. Like, I really love yakky hair, and I really like bobbed hair on me. I don't think I look good, personally, in really long hair, like, straight hair. I don't look good in really long straight hair, in my opinion. I just don't like the way it looks on me. So, I really wanted, like, some short bobbed hair, so that was, like, the first thing I got as soon as this company reached out to me. Before we get into the rating and all of that good stuff, we are going to get into the specs of this hair. Full 360 lace. I'm never gonna wear this up, so I don't know why I keep getting 360 lace types of wigs, but yeah, it is a short Brazilian bob hair, and it's in a, I think, a 12 inch, and honestly, hands down, I love his hair. I love his hair. I don't think you understand how much I love his hair, but I love it. I love this hair. This wig comes in a nice black box. Actually, I didn't like the box. I know it's about the hair, but I didn't like the box. It's a little flimsy to me. It wasn't a nice quality box. Like, y'all know what I'm talking about, right? Like, you know, you get hair, it be coming in a nice box. It's a nice thick box, like a thick, it's thick. You feel me? But it just was a papery type of box. And the box, and in the package, there wasn't anything but eyelashes. It was literally the wig and eyelashes. It would have came with elastic because I had to glue this down. I used lace front glue to glue it down, or whatever the case may be. The pro. This hair is so pretty. It moves so effortless. It feels so free. It's so nice. And listen, y'all, I've been sleeping with this hair, okay? I've been sleeping with this hair for like a week and a half now. Still no tangles, okay? Very minimal shedding, like little bit, but not like, oh my God, a shedding. Like, you barely notice it until you see a hair on the floor and you're like, oh shit, that's my hair. Like, that's the only time you ever notice that they're shedding. Never take it off, honestly. The only time I did take it off was to do my parting space. As you guys saw, I really do not like to part my hair. I don't like my hair with a part. I don't like parts. I'd rather just flip it. Like, I don't know, I like the flipping. I like the way flipping looks. Also, I don't like to really customize the hair much, because I know that a lot of people who watch me are young, and I know that they're most likely not going to be sitting here plucking wigs all day. Like, you gotta be realistic when you do YouTube videos. No 12, 13, 14, 15 year olds about to sit here, bleach knots, and pick, pluck, and customize and do all of that to a wig. Like, not your average teenager is going to do that. So I like to show people what it looks like in its natural state, like, you know, fresh out the box. But I did customize this. All I did was I parted the hair, and I parted the hair, I plucked it a little bit, I threw some concealer in it, and I called it a day. Like, I don't have time for that. But I've worn this in this wet state. I love it wet. Like, it's so amazing wet. In my Q&A, I had it wet. I don't know if y'all seen it. And I like it a lot in its bob state, but I don't feel like straightening this, so I'm just gonna leave it. This is how it looks like when it's just washed and air dried. Like, I did not blow dry it. I did not put any type of iron to it. I didn't do anything to this hair at all. Like, this is what it looks like when it's freshly washed, air dried, and just plopped on your head, okay? That's what I did. Now let's get into the cons. There's this freaking, like, bump in the back of my head, just normal. Y'all know straight hair usually has, like, a lump, you know, usually it'll come with that little lump in the back, and you have to do the moles to get it to lay down. That's why I don't like straight hair. It's just too much maintenance for me. But anyways, what I used to lay down is I used mousse. This is the Tresemme mousse. This is number 4, which is almost the strongest hold. The strongest hold is number 5. And I use this edge control. It is called, it's by On Natural Edge Control 2-Day Hold, Black Castor Oil and Vitamin E. I used both of these on my wig. Like, literally, I took the wig off, I put it on my damn mannequin head, and I, like, legit pressed it down. Like, I put the mousse on first, and then I put in the edge control. I smoothed it down with a fine tooth comb, like a really small comb, and then I scarfed it down for 24 hours. Actually, not even 24 hours, like overnight, so like 8 hours. I put the scarf on, I tied it super tight, and it started to lay down way better. Like, this is a lot flatter than it was before. But I don't like my hair this flat. I don't know, I feel like I had a helmet on my head. I just don't like it this flat. I just did this for the purposes of the video. It's actually a track that is sewed in vertically in the back of this wig. I don't know if it's just my wig or all the wigs that come like that, but it's very annoying, and that's what was causing this bump in my head. Okay, I had like a, you know how like sometimes you it's hard to get a wig to lay flat because it's just not laying flat, and usually you just lay it flat and that's fine. Like, there's a thing right here, and that's why, I don't know if y'all can tell, there's like a little, it's a little bit of a bump right here, and that's where the track is. It's right here. It's like sewed from like right here to right here, and I'm just like, I don't know who sewed this wig, but clearly I didn't have no common sense. But if it wasn't for that, this would have been a perfect 10 for me. I personally give this wig an 8.5, and the only reason I'm not giving it a 10 is, one, the lace was way too sensitive for me. This lace is very sensitive, and me plucking this, I was afraid I was gonna rip the lace. Hey, I don't know, because I did the pull out method. Maybe if I had tweezers, I like to like pull them out because I don't have tweezers. But yeah, this lace is like, I almost ripped this lace numerous times. It's also not a really natural looking lace. You have to bleach the knots. But like I said, I didn't bleach my knots. I didn't care. I just put some concealer in it and I called it a day. And two, I don't understand why there's a vertical lace, there's a vertical track going on in my head. Like, I don't understand. It doesn't make any sense. So now it's time to get into what my subscribers think. Now, I haven't looked at many of these. I only looked at like the first couple when I first posted this post. So I'm going to be doing these on my community tab every time I get some new hair or whatever. And this shall be fun. So I got over, oh my god, 231 comments, 1,000 likes and some change. That's a lot. I'm probably not going to get through all these comments. I'll tell you that right the fuck now. I'm not getting through all of these comments. So, 8, they look good on you, just like the lace front needs to be fixed more. I know, this shit is mad ridiculous. It's cute, but you always look better to me with poofy hair because of your round features. Oh, thank you, you're right. I thought it was just me. That might be why I personally don't like straight hair on me. Like, I feel like my face is way too round. Yo, you right, girl, you right. Thank you, Sadiddy Magnum. And the first comment was from a comment. Thank you, comment. I think the wet look is the cutest. I'm giving it a 9. Thank you, Tarisha. Thank you. It looks good. It's the quality, but needs some plucking for a more natural look. Thank you, Amy. I'm lazy as hell. I'm not doing that. I don't know. Does it look more natural now? I don't know. I tried. I took y'all's advice. Let's see. It looks good quality, but needs some... Oh, wait. 8 when dry, 9 when wet. The beach wave looks nice on you. Thank you. Curls. Y'all nice. Brown skin mommy said it's a no for me. I said rate it. You couldn't just give it a 1 or 2. Like, oh my god. You have to pluck it. To be honest, it's a 4. I know my wigs, and that's definitely a 4. It's cute, but it needs to be plucked at the part so it looks more natural. There is no part in any of these pictures. I don't think I parted it at all in any of those pictures that I posted. The wet is a 10 for sure. 8 because in certain styles it looks cute. The wet and curl wave, but the others aren't as cute. Love you. Yeah, I really do like that. Like, I really do like it wet. If I could get it to stay looking that wet all the time, that'd be life. 7 looks great, but at the top it's not flat and the hairline does not look natural. By the way, can you record your natural hair routine? You always say that you don't spend a lot of time doing your hair. Love you. Mawa Jermaine. Mawa, listen, I'm lazy. Like, a lot of people always ask me to do my natural hair, and it's just like, I don't do anything to it. I wash it. I condition it, I air dry it, I put some castor oil in it, I let it air dry, and I leave it alone. Or sometimes I'll braid it up in like 6 parts to let it, you know, do some curly something while it dries, and then I do what I gotta do for a week. Like, I don't do anything. Like, people really don't believe me when I say I don't do anything to my hair. Like, I really don't. I think it would just be a very boring video. But anyway, 7.5 to 8. Thank you, Michaela? Girl. 9. The only thing I do is pluck the frontal to have a defined part. Otherwise, you look fire. Thank you, Nana Young. Now, let's just scroll through. Because I don't feel like reading just the beginning comments. Maybe I should, like, read some in between. Because 200 comments, that's a lot. Let's see. Princess Precious, you're getting better at wigs. Thank you. I just started this wig thing, so forgive me, y'all. 7, your natural hair is so much prettier, though. Thank you, Kimmy V. 1.. billion. Thank you, Kylia Abdullah. 6, 4, 8. Oh, she rated the different pictures. Damn, really? I ain't like the flip over. I like my flip over. That's all that matters. Wet look is a 10. I don't really like the rest. The wet look looks best, but it needs to be parted and plucked. So probably a 6. Love the wet look. 10, 8. Oh, you cute. I'm loving this look on you. Natural curl with dimension. you are hot in all the slays. Thank you. I would give it an 8. Looks good on you. Thank you. I like all of them, but the middle one is my favorite. I rate them all a 9. 7.5, 7.5, 29, 10. I'm going 10 just because never seen anybody ask people to wait their rig before. Thank you. I gotta get that comment of love. I like it especially when it's wet. The lace front needs to be plucked more. Please part the hair. It's hard to choose. The wig really fits you. You look beautiful. I'm giving the wet look a 9 and a dry look an 8. Okay, I think that's it. I think most of everybody gave me a 7, an 8, or a 9. There was a couple of 4s out here. But for the most part, I think everybody kind of liked the wig, but mainly in its wet state. I love the wet state. If I could wear it in its wet state every day, I would. I like my hair, and that's all that matters. So y'all, yeah, that was hating on my hair. But I was like, no, y'all wasn't hating. Y'all just giving y'all honest opinion. It's whatever. It is what it is. On to the next hair. If you like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. If you didn't like it, it's okay. You can give it a big thumbs down. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, follow me on social media, do all that. Everything you need is down in the description box below. But like I said, I'm going to be doing these rate my wig videos on a regular basis. If you want this hair, everything you need is going to be down in the description box below. Get your wig. It's very cheap, very affordable, and very good quality. Like, I'm gonna be wearing this more often. Like, look at this. If you want to see more, make sure you smash that subscribe button, smash that like button, and smash that share button. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, do all that, and I'ma see y'all next time. Cherry Pie.